The push to waive patents on COVID-19 vaccines to make them available more globally is accelerating after the United States endorsed the idea. French President Macron voiced support at a vaccine center today in a bid to increase production for poorer nations.
I completely favor this opening up of intellectual property. Today, the strangle points that complicate access to the vaccines will, at some point, be the price in access to intellectual property. Today, it is technological transfer and the capacity to produce.
German Chancellor Angela Merkel spoke out against a patent waiver today. Ultimately, the World Trade Organization, with 164 members, will decide. But opposition from just one could derail the effort. We'll return to this later in the program. In India, the COVID emergency is growing ever more desperate. New infections have topped 400,000 for a second time, with nearly 4,000 deaths in 24 hours. Hospitals in New Delhi and elsewhere are in crisis. And the government today sharply increased medical oxygen shipments under court order. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken warned today that global vaccinations must move faster. He said in an interview that, quote, if we don't do more, if the entire world doesn't do more, the world won't be vaccinated until 2024. Blinken spoke in Ukraine, where he also reassured President Volodymyr Zelensky of U.S. support and said Russia's recent massing of troops was reckless.
We're aware that Russia has withdrawn some forces from the border of Ukraine, but we also see that significant forces remain there, significant equipment remains there. We're monitoring the situation very, very closely.
Blinken also urged Ukraine to step up efforts against internal political corruption. A police raid in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, left 25 people dead today, including one officer. Heavily armed suspects leapt from roof to roof to escape the firefight. Authorities said the operation targeted a gang of drug traffickers. At least 10 suspects were arrested. Back in this country, President Biden pitched his infrastructure plan worth $2.3 trillion in Republican Louisiana. He spoke in Lake Charles in front of a bridge that he said was 20 years past its intended lifespan. The Republican mayor joined him to appeal for federal aid. The president also stopped in New Orleans. Florida is the latest Republican-run state to impose new voting rules, including limits on mail-in ballots and drop boxes. Governor Ron DeSantis staged a bill signing today on the Fox and Friends TV program. He argued that the changes will stop fraud and suggested that he would have gone even further.
I'm not a fan of drop boxes at all, to be honest with you, but the legislature wanted to keep them, but they need to be monitored. You can't just leave these boxes out where there's no supervision, where they're in all hours of the night. So the drop boxes will be available only when they're monitored and during regular voting hours.
Opponents said that the measure makes it harder for the elderly and minorities to vote, and they quickly filed suit to block it. A national moratorium on evicting renters during the pandemic will stay in effect for now. A federal judge in Washington, D.C. had initially ruled that the Centers for Disease Control had no authority to impose the ban. But late Wednesday, she put the ruling on hold to consider the Justice Department's appeal. New jobless claims in the U.S. have dropped to a pandemic low. They fell by nearly 100,000 last week, down to 498,000. The Labor Department also reports that productivity rebounded in the first quarter, rising at an annual rate of 5.4%. And on Wall Street, banks and tech stocks led a broad rally. The Dow Jones Industrial Average gained 318 points to a record close, 34,548. The NASDAQ rose 50 points, and the S&P 500 was up 34. Still to come on the NewsHour, the Arizona GOP continues an election review despite zero evidence of fraud. A wide-ranging discussion with former Secretary of Defense and CIA Director Robert Gates. We examine the logistical challenges of sharing vaccines with countries in need, and much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour. from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West, from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.